22-year-old Addie Karen likes to have a goal.
I need to have different things. And as long as I like it, I keep going.
Addie is a champion swimmer.
I just swim.
Breaststroke?
I do all strokes.
Yeah.
And then I go to the small meets, you know, the mini meets, and you get your times. And then when I see, oh, I need to go faster, then I work harder.
We caught up with Addie at the pool at Colby Sawyer College in New London. She swims here twice a week. Addie has competed around the world for the U.S. Masters Organization. She has won countless medals.
And so here, swimming different places.
We say countless because she really doesn't keep track. She even gives some of them away. She is that humble.
First place.
First place. What country was this?
In South Korea.
South Korea. Mm-hmm. You saved this one.
Yeah, well, they're coming like this.
How long did you wear your medals for? 5 minutes?
None.
You didn't even put it on?
No.
Addie was born and raised in the Netherlands. Her family still lives there. She came to the U.S. at age 23 because she was curious about America. She wasn't planning to stay until she met her husband, Chet, on a blind date. They married 4 months later.
I had friends that said, it'll never work. It'll be over in 6 months. Well, 6 months is still here. So.
57 years.
You're right.
Addie has competed in meets from Morocco to South Korea, Japan, Russia, Australia, and New Zealand. And she usually travels alone.
I don't like to wait for people because a lot of people say, oh, they'd like to come. And I'm not going to sit there. I just do it. I just go.
Addie recalls arriving in Casablanca, Morocco at night. Her scheduled driver didn't show up at the airport, so she caught a ride with some strangers she met on the plane.
I got there and it's in the middle of the night, pitch black. And the bus driver got out, talked to this guy in Arabic, and I got my suitcase, and the gate closed. And then I sat there on my suitcase, and I go, oh well, there's nothing else I can do.
Addie may be casual about traveling alone, but she takes her swimming very seriously. She has even broken records, but she doesn't like to make a big fuss over it.
I've broken records in the 400 IM and also broken records in the breaststroke. I mean, the records, they get broken again.
Right.
So, you know.
But at the time, that must make you feel pretty good.
Well, most of the time, they tell me and I go, oh, that's nice. I don't
know. Addie and Chet share their home with Jana, their seventh Great Dane. Their home filled with keepsakes from the Netherlands. Addie recently took up oil painting, and you'll find her paintings on the wall throughout their home. But outside is where we find her other true passion.
And when you're not swimming, you're spending most of your time in the barn.
In the barn and outside, like with Jana, like we're hiking for it. Jana, no jumping.
Bo and Hawk are Addie's horses. She's been competing for years.
Hi, guys. Hi, Bo. Hi, Hawk. You're good? Yeah?
Working in the barn for Addie is her relaxation. Addie started riding competitively in her 40s. It was something she always wanted to do.
I was petrified. I was literally shaking. Petrified. But I hate giving into fear. So I went. And at one point, I fell off. And I landed underneath the horse. And I go, oh, that's not too bad. And so I did. First walk, trot, canter, and then I got into jumping, and then I did, for many, many years, I did eventing.
Addie keeps her ribbons from her horse competitions with her swim medals, but as we mentioned, she doesn't like to brag, so we didn't get to see all of them.
Riccione, Italy. So, that's it. Done.
That's your box of treasures.
Yeah, some of them. But I don't know where all the other, I put them somewhere and then I forget about it.
When Addie is not competing, she and Chet enjoy skiing in Austria and Switzerland, where they like to go ski base jumping. Even though she admits she doesn't like heights, she also doesn't like fear. Closer to home, Addie enjoys mountain biking and riding in her Spyder. She gave up her motorcycle a couple years ago. She also stopped doing triathlons in her 60s. As for swimming, Addie is training for her next international swim meet.
So the next one for the world is Singapore, and that's next year. That I will be going. And I'll be really working harder for Singapore, so because I'll be going there. So, you want to go?
Yeah, sure. I'd love to go.
Good, good. So you can be my helper and my trainer. I do like goals, yeah. Yeah, that keeps me going.